Here we can see some benchmarks of the game GTA 4 from the year 2008. As we can see, it was totally impossible to lock the game at 60 FPS even with the fastest CPU available on the market. According to PCGH, they even reduced the range of visibility to 50% just because higher values would have been reserved for graphics cards with more than 1 GB of VRAM and would have needed even more horsepower. Of course, since the year 2008, there have been many CPU and GPU releases, and therefore I ask myself if it is possible now to run the game at a locked 120Hz in the year 2020. As you can see, this system is equipped with an R5 5600X overclocked to 4.665 GHz on all cores, 64 GB of GDDR4 3200 RAM and a Radeon 7 overclocked to 1200 MHz on the memory and 1840 MHz on the core. To know what frame rate we are able to run a game on, we have to take a look at two different limits in our PC. Probably the most important component of a gaming PC is the graphics card. The second most important component of a gaming PC, of course, is the processor. It has to be able to feed our GPU all the draw calls and calculate the physics and AI in the game in time, so our GPU is not limited by the performance of our CPU. To do this, we are going to lower the resolution of the game to just 720p. Just because if we increase the resolution of the game, we are just asking our GPU to render more pixels for us. But in the first step, we want to find the limit of our CPU, the R5 5600X, and therefore we are going to test the game at the lowest resolution we are able to play in. Of course, we could play in even lower resolutions, but then the game just looks like shit and can be pretty hard to handle, especially in even lower resolutions than 720p. As we can see in this first scene, on the graph here, we are pretty close to our desired 120 FPS lock. At least as long as we are on the inside. As soon as we move to the outside of this building, we are getting a way more unstable frame rate. Even though we are just at a resolution of 720p, as I drive around here, the chance of holding our 120 FPS lock are fading pretty fast. At this point, we have only one chance of stabilizing our frame rate, and that's through lowering our in-game settings. To release some of the stress our CPU is crumbling under, I first reduce our draw distance and the vehicle density. At this point, we gained about 10 to 20 frames per second, but we are nonetheless far off of our desired 120 FPS lock. So because all of our tries failed until now, I'm going to try now to turn all the in-game settings to the absolute minimum to find out if it is even possible to hold our 120 FPS lock under any circumstances. As you can see, we are pretty close here, but still not there, so I guess the answer is no. It is simply not possible to attain a 120 FPS lock in GTA 4, especially if you don't like to play at 720p with the most shitty graphics you can even imagine. So for me, the next question is, can we even attain a 60 FPS lock? Let's turn all the settings up again and take a look at our 60 FPS performance. Surprisingly, we are still not 100% stable at 60 FPS, and for all people who wonder here, this game is running from an PCIe 4.0 SSD, which should have absolutely no problems loading the assets of this game fast enough. So the final solution of our test is that we are not able to run our game at a locked 120 Hz. And even stable 60 Hz are no easy feat in 2020. GTA 4 was the first open world game using Rockstar's Rage engine, and even though graphics improved during the years, it could be way more easy reaching 120 FPS in today's games, just because they are more optimized for current hardware and the game engines are way more polished nowadays. Therefore, it would be interesting to repeat this test with GTA 5 or even Red Dead Redemption 2. I hope you like this video, and if you do so, I would be pleased if you leave me a thumbs up or even subscribe to my channel. This is Michael, see you next time.